Hello guys, in today's video we will learn about e-commerce. Before proceeding to the lesson, let's have a look at the learning outcome. We will learn about types of transaction in e-commerce. E-commerce is also known as electronic commerce, refers to the buying and selling of goods or services using the internet. It involves the transfer of money and data to execute these transactions. E-commerce is often used to refer to the sale of physical products online, but it can also describe any kind of commercial transaction that is facilitated through the internet. Now, let's look at the differences between e-commerce and traditional commerce. Firstly, e-commerce is a form of online shopping where users can buy goods and services from their electronic devices such as laptop, mobile, or tablet. Meanwhile, traditional commerce is a traditional approach to buy goods and services in person, which involves face-to-face dealing. Secondly, e-commerce is used to save valuable time and money, while traditional commerce is ancient and still in usage where digital network is not reachable. Thirdly, e-commerce is in electronic or digital mode only, while traditional commerce can be in any form which is non-electronic or manual form. Furthermore, e-commerce is available round the clock. Meanwhile, traditional commerce is available during limited time as prescribed by the law and based on the type of business. Besides, e-commerce is automated processing of business transactions. Meanwhile, traditional commerce is manual processing of traditional business transactions. There are many types of transactions in e-commerce. Firstly, let's look at business-to-consumer transaction. The term business-to-consumer, B2C, refers to the process of selling products and services directly between a business and consumers who are the end users of its products or services. B2C became immensely popular during the dot-com boom of the late 1990s when it was mainly used to refer to online retailers who sold products and services to consumers through the internet. In this form of e-commerce, businesses must develop attractive electronic marketplaces to sell products and services to consumers. Many companies offer e-commerce websites that provide virtual storefronts, multimedia catalogs, interactive order processing, electronic payment, and online customer support. For example, Dell, Amazon.com, Zalora, and etc. Secondly, let's learn about business-to-business transaction. Business-to-business, also called B2B, is a form of transaction between businesses, such as one involving a manufacturer and wholesaler, or a wholesaler and a retailer. Business-to-business refers to business that is conducted between companies rather than between a company and individual consumer. For example, many companies offer secure internet or extranet e-commerce catalog websites for their business customers and suppliers. Producers and traditional commerce wholesalers typically operate with this type of electronic commerce. For example, Intel sell microprocessor to Dell. Now, let's study about customer-to-customer transaction, which is also known as C2C. C2C is a commerce between private individuals or consumers. It is a business model whereby customers can trade with each other, typically in an online environment. C2C marketing has soared in popularity with the arrival of the internet and companies. Private individuals or consumers Sometimes businesses can buy from and sell to one another in an auction process at an auction website or classified ads at portal websites. For example, eBay, Alibaba.com and Lelong.com. Business to government transaction is also called as B2G. B2G is the sale and marketing of goods and services to federal, state or local agencies. The examples of B2G transaction are business pay taxes, sell goods to government agencies and etc. Now, let's study about government to business transaction, G2B. G2B is when a government does business with other governments as well as with other businesses. For examples, auctions, tenders, and etc. Government to citizens transaction is also known as G2C. It is the electronic commerce activities performed between the government and its citizens or consumers, including paying taxes, registering vehicles, and providing information and services. Now, let's learn about customer to business transaction, which is also called as C2B. C2B is the electronic commerce business model in which consumers can offer products and services to companies and the companies pay the consumers. The business model is a complete reversal of the traditional business model in which companies offer goods and services to consumers. We can see the C2B model at work in blogs or internet forums in which the author offers a link back to an online business, thereby facilitating the purchase of a product, for which the author might receive affiliate revenues from a successful sale. Finally, let's study about business to employee B2E transaction. It is an electronic commerce uses an intra-business network which allows companies to provide products and/or services to their employees. Typically, companies use B2E networks to automate employee-related corporate processes. B2E portals have to be compelling to the people who use them. Companies are competing for eyeballs of their employees with eBay, Yahoo, and thousands of other websites. There is a huge percentage of traffic to consumer websites comes from the people who are connecting to the net at the office. Well, that's all for this chapter. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you all could understand today's lesson. If you have any doubts or questions, please feel free to ask in the comment section below and don't forget to subscribe our channel for more videos. Thank you so much. See you all next video. Good luck.